Also this morning... Sun is shining in the sky. There ain't a cloud in sight. Jeff Lynne, Mr. Blue Sky himself, and of course behind many other hits for the band ELO, is going to be here to tell us why, after all these years, he's still pinching himself over his massive success. And here on Breakfast, Jeff Lynne, Uber producer, sometime Traveling Wilbury, lead electrician with the Electric Light Orchestra, is going to be here to tell us what part technology has played in recreating some of his old classics.
And working with some of the legends of music over the last few years. Time now to get the news, travel and weather where you are. See you in a couple of minutes with the headlines.
Some of the biggest rock hits of the 70s, but now he's decided to re-record them. Jeff Lynne is going to be here with us on the sofa.
There's so much to look forward to.
It's rocking, isn't it?
Yeah.
So much
Adele.
Music this morning. Yeah.
ELO, Diary of Horace Wimp, do you remember that? All around the world.
Yeah.
Fantastic
yeah.
tunes, aren't they?
Mr.
Showing
Blue
my
Seed.
Age, showing my age, yeah. On a sky, hopefully a day of blue skies as well.
Thank you.
Now, Mr. Blue Sky himself is here, a.k.a. Jeff Lynne, the man behind so many things. Where should we start? ELO, morning, Jeff. We're going to talk to you
morning.
In a minute about the album. Just really quickly, were you a James Bond fan? Are you a James Bond fan?
Yeah, I am, yeah.
I knew you would be.
But you'd love to write the theme for a Bond movie, wouldn't you?
You betcha. I would love it, actually. I would love to have a go at that, yeah.
To be honest, I'm surprised you haven't. You've done so much. We'll talk to you lots in a minute. First, okay. We're going to have a last quick look at what is happening where you are. See you in a minute. Welcome back. He is the man behind some of the biggest rock hits of the 70s. Jeff Lynne was the driving force behind ELO and has worked alongside artists like George Harrison, Bob Dylan. The list is literally endless.
It is, and now he's gone back to re-record some of his most memorable tracks. We're going to speak to Jeff again in a minute. But first, let's have a listen to his new version of his classic song, Mr. Blue Sky.
Sun is shining in the sky.
And Jeff Lynne is here. Welcome. I mean, I'm sure lots of your fans will have thought, you know what, it was perfect already.
Well, you know, I used to think it was good when I did it.
Yeah.
And then, like lately, the last few years, I've listened to it, it's come on the radio, I thought, hang on, I thought it was better than that. Because it's just some of the sounds on there are a bit woolly, you know, and it's a bit covered and closed. And I wanted it to have more clarity and just be more punch, you know, and just come out more at it. And it was just always a bit... So anyway...
It sounds very fresh now, doesn't
Thank
it?
Thank you, yes, that's what... I polished it up.
So when you listen to that now, you just heard it, is it now perfect? Are you now...
I'm now
you don't want to change it again, Jeff, do you?
No. I'm not going to change again for another 25 years.
It's interesting because you've done a documentary as well about ELO, and you've got some extremely famous people talking about you. Sir Paul McCartney is just one of them. And they all seem to say that you bring a bit of magic to songs. And how do you go about doing it? What's the sort of approach?
I suppose it's just the way I do stuff. You know, it's the way I produce records is different, a lot different from the way most people do it. I usually do it backwards, you know, I mean, and I don't mean record the song backwards, but I don't use the same methods as other people.
Mm-hmm.
I approach it from a slightly different way and come up with a different sound. And I do, people say I have my own sound, that, you know, when I do make the record, it sounds like me, and you can tell. And I hope that's true.
And it's all, a lot of it's down to the sort of recording studio, isn't it? And you've got one in your home and you do a lot of the work there, do you, yourself?
I do all my recording there, yeah. I just spent the last 3 years, 6 days a week, making this album, Mr. Blue Sky, and Longwave, my other album, my other brand new album.
And Longwave is called Longwave because these are the tracks that you used to listen to on Longwave Radio in Birmingham growing up, and you wanted to make them yourself, give it your own spin.
Yeah, when I was a kid, it was a big, the old big plywood radio with a big 12-inch speaker, lovely soft bass and no top.
And you, how did you choose the songs? Were they songs from your childhood that sort of you heard on that radio, or how did you go about it?
Well, some of them I actually hated when I used to hear them when I was a kid. And I only learned to love them when I just learned how to play them in the past couple of years. Like, for instance, If I Loved You from Carousel. I never dreamed in a million years that I'd be singing that flipping thing. But, but it was actually the most marvellous thing, most fun I ever had recording it. I just loved it. And once I got it right, I was frightened to death of singing it. I was going, oh, it's going to sound like me singing it, you know, from Birmingham. It's not going to sound like this big, fancy American job, you know. But anyway, I did it, and it sounded not bad at all, so I went in and tried about another 10 times, and I got it.
Let's have a listen to one of the tracks. Mercy, Mercy is that the one that we've got here. We've got that we can play.
Overboard and drown. Don't leave me. Have mercy. Have mercy, baby.
There's so many stories that you could tell us, and one of the ones is how did the Traveling Wilburys come about? Because that was an extraordinary group of people, wasn't it?
It was a fantastic group. It came about with I was producing George Harrison's album Cloud Nine, and we sang out together every night after the session. You know, we'd have a couple of drinks and we'd have these like discussions. And one night he said, "You know what, me and you should have a group." And I said, "Oh yeah, great, I'd love it, yeah." And who should we have in it? He said, "Oh, Bob Dylan." I said, "Oh right, Bob Dylan, yeah. How about Roy Orbison?" "Yeah, sure, Roy, that'd be great." And we both wanted Tom Petty. And the next day they'd all joined. He'd phoned them all and they'd all joined. So. That was it.
It's like fantasy band, isn't it?
Yeah. Totally. And then we just had the most marvellous fun hanging out in LA, writing all the songs around a table, five acoustic guitars, and it was just fantastic.
I know you live in California now, don't you?
I do, yeah.
Do you come back here often? And lots of people asking this morning, are you going to tour with these new albums?
Well, I'm not actually going to tour right yet, a while. But I do... I do come back here every so often, yeah. I do like coming back.
You say you're not going to tour now, but you might?
I never say never, but you know, touring's not my favourite thing.
Isn't it?
No, unfortunately. But I wouldn't mind doing it if the circumstances were right.
Okay.
Lots of people from Birmingham saying, come back here if you're going to start your tour here if you ever do it.
I certainly would. That's where I'd go first.
Okay.
Just one thing before you go. The sunglasses, do they ever come off?
Only if I fall out of bed.
What a great answer. It's been an absolute pleasure to meet you. Thank you very much for coming in.
Great to meet you too. Thank you.
Jeff's two albums, One's Not Enough, Long Wave and Mr. Blue Sky, the very best of the Electric Light Orchestra, will be released on Monday. And that BBC Four documentary we were talking about is on tonight on BBC Four at 9 o'clock.
Yes, absolutely. That's all we have time for this morning. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.
See you then. Bye-bye.